From angry letters to angrier lawsuits. Should a deal go rotten if you sympathize with bin Laden? Pittsburgh Steeler Rashard Mendenhall is suing Hanesbrand, Inc. for a breach of contract following the running back's dismissal over his surmise of Osama's demise. Shortly after the Navy SEALs sealed the Al-Qaeda chief's fate, Mendenhall sealed his with the following tweet, quote, "What kind of person celebrates death? It's amazing how people can hate a man they have never even heard speak. We've only heard one side." And then there was this little ditty on 9/11 conspiracy theories. "We'll never know what really happened. I just have a hard time believing a plane could take a skyscraper down, demolition style." Says Mendenhall's attorney of the suit, quote again, "For Rashard, this really is not about the money. This is about whether he can express his opinion." Meanwhile, the world wants to know, what's on Mendenhall's off-season menu?
Delicious.
They didn't show anybody eat it, though. So it's probably
no, it
fine.
Escaped. Oh, it ran off.
Yeah, exactly.
He's a vegetarian.
Yes, exactly. Hey, I got to ask you, Kinsey, because you're the Twitter, you're the social network expert. Isn't it Twitter's fault? Should Twitter be banned?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely not. No, this young man made some absolutely ignorant statements. Mm-hmm. When you're a celebrity, you have to become a brand to stay relevant, and he is a brand. And it's just like any other strategic partnership. Mm-hmm. When somebody endorses you, they want you because they want your audience. They want to get in front of your audience. And if you do something that could affect their brand and you know, ruin their reputation, absolutely cut ties, divorce them, get away from them. I completely agree with what... The champion sports?
There you go.
Champion sports. Yes. I completely agree with champion sports.
The vision of under Haynes, I believe.
Yes, exactly. Yes. I'm a big fan of Haynes, I have to say.
But don't you think there's something about men who just shouldn't Twitter either in their underwear or when they're trying to sell underwear?
Yeah, I think you're right. It's always, underwear is the underlying factor here. See how I said underlying? I did that totally by accident. Hey, Joe, you told me in the green room that you agree with everything Mendenhall tweeted, and then some. So defend the lawsuit.
Yeah, I thought he didn't say enough.
Yeah.
This is one of those things I wanted to be on his side, because I was like, hey, a guy can express himself. But as you read the tweet, you fall off.
Yeah.
You know, you're like, what kind of person celebrates death? Okay, I get it. It's amazing how people can hate a man they never heard, they even heard speak. All right, maybe all right. We only heard one side of this. Okay, you lost me. So it's, you know, it's a tough one, man.
Yeah. Yeah. You know. Yeah. So basically, you agree that he should have lost the endorsement deal.
Yeah. I mean, I'm always torn with stuff like this. Do I agree with what he said? No, I don't. Do I think you have to represent the people you're in business with? Yes, I do. But do I also think that we live in this culture where everything is so kid glove handled these days that you can't? This is an extreme example. There are people saying far less insightful things than this that are being reprimanded and having their money taken away.
Yeah.
And that's the problem.
KT, what do you think? Should every athlete endorsement contract have some kind of like social media clause in it that says whatever you say there will be used against you?
You know, look, let's use a little common sense. I mean, he says this is all about his right to express himself. And it's not about the money. Mm-hmm. Well, so he's got a lawsuit. Is he going to give the money? If he wins the lawsuit, is he going to give the money to victims of September 11th?
And he's suing for like $1 million. Yeah. He should sue for $1.
More than that, I think. It's the contract. It's $1 million.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. Should have read the story, I suppose. Hey, Bill, he's kind of a jerk.
Yeah. I'm going to concur with you on this
Yeah,
one, Greg.
I think so. He's just a jerk.
To get the letters.
Yeah, you are.
He does not have the legal legs to stand on. This will be thrown out in court. I can't believe it's getting any publicity to begin with. Having said that, the dude runs the 40 in 4 seconds and change. So if the Bears sign him, I'm taking all this back.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm throwing that out there right now.
Yeah.
Call me.
You know, my closing thought on this is that, you know, he's apparently a 9/11 truther, according to his tweets, which I think he took that one down.
Right.
And whenever you run into that, you always should say to them, you're actually behind it. Like, if you run into a 9/11 truther, always say, I believe you did it, and then demand that they prove that they didn't do it.
Because
that's what they do to us every day, and they waste so much of our time with these stupid conspiracies.
I got another good one. If you run into another 9/11 truther, and he's talking about it, you should respond by hitting him upside the head with a cinder block. I've always found that there is no comeback for it.
Wow, that's an interesting response.
I don't kids think, out there.
I don't
the
think
playground.
I don't endorse that whatsoever. Ooh, nice segue. Yes. From Mendenhall to preventing a fall. So, should seesaws be outlawed and monkey bars barred? Well, as the New York Times reports, some researchers are questioning the value of safety-first playgrounds, which prohibits stuff like the jungle gym, overhead ladders, trapeze rings, and, of course, broken glass mountain. God, I loved broken glass mountain. They argue that even if children do suffer fewer injuries, and that's still not certain, boring playgrounds may stunt emotional development, leaving our brats with anxieties and fears that are worse than broken bones. Says one professor from Norway. Norway, like you have schools. Children need to encounter risk and overcome fears on the playground. But sadly and stupidly, in recent decades, so-called dangerous playground equipment has disappeared because of parental concerns, federal guidelines, and the biggest reason of all, fear of lawsuits. We asked some local kids to comment.
Thank you, YouTube.
Yeah. Never get tired of that. Hey, Joe.
Yeah.
Welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Do you buy this theory that safer playgrounds create scared kids later in life?
Well, look, I actually do think they should remove the slides and the monkey bars and the swing sets and just install giant tampons for these kids.
Why? Because they're soft, right? All right, I just want to follow through with that. Because they're soft and they won't hurt anybody.
No, it's ridiculous. This is. I mean, do you see the? There is a sort of change or theme through these stories that we're covering here.
Yeah.
With this, it starts with these kids. You want to put them in a risk-free environment. You want to give them no danger to surround them whatsoever. Mm-hmm. And then we're creating this society of opinionless, voiceless people that can't say anything they ever want to say. They can't express themselves ever. We live in this completely reactionless society. It's ridiculous.
Wow.
Man. It's ridiculous.
That was quite deep, Joe.
Well, I've been physically threatened many times on the road as a comedian for things I say on stage.
That is true.
Yeah, it's nice. It's nice.
And Colonel West is going to be added to that list.
Yeah,
and he can kill you from Florida.
Yeah.
Just by thinking bad thoughts, he can kill you.
Trust me, I've regretted the joke every second.
I would regret it too. I think he might be showing up at some point at one of your gigs. Hey, KT, do you think kids are missing out on the danger of youth?
Look, we have five children, and what is America raising? A bunch of wimps, right? Mm-hmm. There are no playgrounds that have anything dangerous on them, and nobody has to win or lose because that would be just so terrible, and it would really hurt their sense of self-esteem. Meanwhile, what else is going on in the world? Tiger moms.
Yeah.
What are the Chinese raising? Yeah. Kids who study all the time, kids who don't play with games, kids who do homework, kids who play the violin for hours a day. And what are we going to have? A bunch of wimps playing with the sort of things you just recommended.
800-pound wimps.
800-pound wimps. Real quick, Kinsey, you've got 8 kids. How do you feel about this idea?
Well, I don't have 8 children, just so Grandpa knows. And secondly, I think that we should have so many playgrounds because I don't like fat babies and I just want skinny babies.
All right.
I don't like skinny babies.
All right, I got to move on.
I was kidding.
Coming up on a hard out, that's TV talk. Coming up, can you kill a man with a plastic fork and 3 rubber bands? Kinsey Schofield explains what happened to her ex-boyfriend. But first, why was Paris peeved? We'll discuss the story that Bret Baier tonight refused to report.